Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a real honor to welcome you to tonight's gala. We gather tonight to celebrate this evening's honorees, to be inspired by their stories, and the impact they're having in our communities. We acknowledge the many NCLR affiliates for all they do to secure social, economic, and educational empowerment among Latinos. And we recognize the outstanding work of Jenny Murguia and her team for providing a strong voice and a coordinated vision for the more than 50 million Hispanics across the country. Your tireless efforts as leaders, partners, and advocates has strengthened the visibility of NCLR and left a lasting impact on the national stage. We've had four amazing days here in Los Angeles. The sessions were thought-provoking and provided thorough insight into many of the Latino community's most pressing issues. From healthcare to jobs and education, you brought together the most influential individuals, organizations, institutions, and companies, providing a forum for all of us to connect, learn, and further our work to impact lasting social change. For more than 30 years, UPS has been proud to be counted among NCLR supporters and partners. From helping to expand your affiliate network, to financial support for capacity building, family literacy, and scholarships, we've invested over $10 million to help you achieve success. Thank you. And we don't just invest our dollars, we also invest our time. I'm proud to share a few weeks ago, our CEO-elect publicly announced a commitment that UPSers around the world will contribute 20 million hours. That's right, 20 million hours of service to all of our communities by 2020. But nothing gives us more pride than the opportunity to support Latino youth who are striving to achieve their GED or high school diploma, specifically through the Escalera program. Helping these students develop their academic and life skills allows them to strive for opportunities they've never before imagined. It's an important reminder of the impact partnerships such as ours can achieve. Through tutoring and test preparation, college visits, and community service projects, these students assume leadership roles and work in teams. Some choose to go on to college or receive vocational training, while others enter the workforce directly. But each of them leaves the program already knowing that they can be successful and ready for whatever the future throws at them. We actually have some of the Escalera students joining us this evening. I'm going to ask if those students would please stand. And I ask that you all join me in recognizing their success by giving them a warm round of applause. Since this evening is all about celebrating and having some fun, I'll close my remarks tonight with a contest. At your seat, you'll find a gift from UPS. It's a discount card from the UPS store. So I want you to take a look and see if there's a red star on your card. Go ahead, take a look. If so, if you have that red star on your card, you've just won a $500 gift card for products and services at the UPS stores. Do we have a winner? You're still looking for that red star. I know somebody has it. Okay, anyway, just a little bit about the card. Okay, we have a winner. Just a little bit about the card. It's not only good for today, but it's good for the rest of 2014, so it may help lighten up that load as you go home, so keep that in mind. So on behalf of all the UPSers, we want to congratulate tonight's honorees and our Escalera scholars. We extend our best wishes to NCLR as it moves forward in providing a valuable and inspiring resource for our communities. Thank you and enjoy the evening.
Gracias, Mr. Ruiz, and to UPS for their tremendous support. Representing one of the evening's co-sponsors, Amtrak, please welcome Manager of Reservation Sales Call Center, Eric Zamora.
Muy buenas noches. Saludos. My name is Eric Zamora. I was born in El Salvador, Central America, Salvadoreños. Gracias. I moved here to the United States when I was 3 years old. I grew up in the city of Walnut, if any of you know where that's at. I've also lived in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, and that's where I... Go Philly! That's where I learned to love train travel. I experienced a lot of it and saw the impact that it had on the people's lives in the East Coast. When Amtrak asked me to speak tonight at the gala, I was beyond excited, very thrilled. This is my first time here attending, and I'm very honored to be amongst you all at this important event. This is Amtrak's seventh year as sponsors supporting the NCLR. We're especially proud to continue our support in Los Angeles this year. Such an important center for both Amtrak and the Latino community. Amtrak, as you know, is America's railroad, and it's a company that believes in getting people from point A to point B, but we do so with so many amenities and so many other things. We bring people together in a way that no other travel company can. Amtrak provides service for over 500 cities in 46 states and 3 Canadian provinces. An average of 85,000 people travel with Amtrak on every day. At the Riverside Call Center, where I work, we have been hiring more staff each year for the past 6 years to handle the incoming calls for our call center. Amtrak has a lot to offer to the Latino community. Our outreach is in Amtrak.com, the Spanish language website, Amtrak Español, a targeted microsite, DescubreNorteamerica.com, and we support the Spanish language print and broadcast media via paid advertising. Our goal for all travelers is to be able to enjoy the journey by rail without any barriers. From working in the call center, I've learned that so many Latinos don't know and are not familiar with the benefits of traveling with our company. Being here at the NCLR Expo has given me and Amtrak the perfect opportunity to share that information with our community here. For example, did you know that children ages 2 to 12 ride half off with Amtrak? Amtrak is also very economical and a great way to travel and visit family and friends across the country, also for family vacations, etc. It's less stressful than driving, as you all know. And there are so many amenities that come with the trip. Amtrak is a very diverse company, and our journey is made possible by a diverse workforce that extends from the ticket counters to train cars, mechanical shops, and corporate offices. Thank you for this opportunity, and congratulations to all of you on another successful conference. We appreciate the great work that you are all doing under the leadership of your president and CEO, Janet Murguia. Ms. Murguia, thank you for your continued commitment to the public, public service, and for being a strong voice in our Latino community. Gracias por todo lo que hacen. Thank you all for everything that you do. I also want to thank your board of director chairman, Jorge Plasencia. For all his contributions to our community. Gracias por todo y por dejarme participar en este evento. Es un placer representar a Amtrak y nuestra comunidad latina aquí en nuestra bella ciudad de Los Ángeles. Muchas gracias. Buenas noches.
Thank you, Mr. Zamora. Joining us on behalf of tonight's co-sponsor, Southwest Airlines, welcome Manager of Community Affairs and Grassroots, Christine Ortega.
Hello. Some of you know that I landed in LA with a really frightening problem. I felt like a desperate child in an unknown city because I forgot my purse in San Antonio. I had no ID, I had no credit card, I had no money, and I got a lift from a virtual stranger at the LA International Airport. I have not missed a beat since I got to the conference because of all the kindness that NCLR has shown to me this week. So I think that this is something truly inspiring that happens here at NCLR. It's overwhelming to be with so many national and talented leaders here. It can be very intimidating being with all of you, as a matter of fact. It's like wearing Spanx that are too tight. It feels really uncomfortable. I recently had a conversation relevant to what I find that happens at NCLR about an artistic inspiration, imagination, and ordinariness. Cesar Martinez from Texas is one of our most treasured artists, with masterpieces that you can find at the Smithsonian, at the Museum of Modern Art, and even in Paris, France. I asked Cesar, as one of the greatest artists of our time, how do you find inspiration? And he looked at me and he goes, Christine, I am not an artist. As a board member of the Smithsonian Institute's Latino Center, I'm not sharing that one at the next board meeting. But Cesar said, I'm not an artist. But I find inspiration rooted in who I am as an individual and as a Chicano. He sees something ordinary, and he says to himself, I can do that. And then he just sets out to do it. It takes us out a really long time, he told me, to finish a piece of work, a piece of art. He reworks it, he changes it, changes colors, materials, he experiments with all kinds of things. And he just keeps at it until it looks right, until it looks like it's done. So from looking at something ordinary in his life and adding some hard work and inspiration, he takes that and makes something truly extraordinary out of it. This is the same thing that happens at NCLR. You're engaged in the design of our future through your expertise, your craft, your kindness. You are reworking the vision for all of us into the future. You just keep at it until it looks right, just like a master artist. Inspiration, we know, comes from those who are born with the drive to think, create, and aspire. But inspiration also comes from all the social interaction that we see here. So in the spirit of finding your own imagination and to celebrate another successful conference under the leadership of Janet Murguia and Jorge, everyone here will receive a $100 love voucher to use on a future trip on Southwest Airlines. Don't clap too much, I've only got 3 minutes. Okay, so not that this group needs this asterisk, but please note that this gift is a cash contribution. It has a monetary value, and some of us may be prohibited from taking it. So please pick up your voucher at the end of the gala, only if no one will get their asterisk kicked for it. I hope that this will inspire you to connect to something that's important in your life. And finally, as you design our future through your hard work, it begs the question, who is going to own this work of art? Who is going to own our future? Is it going to be those who are passing legislation and are driving a wedge between our families? Is it going to be those power brokers on Wall Street? Is it going to be those blocking children from finding safety when they have no ID, no credentials, no credit card, and no cash? Seeing the dedication of your craft, being here, I'm grateful. I am truly grateful for your unfailing work in the design of our future, because our future will belong to all of us who can imagine it. Thank you.
Muchísimas gracias, Ms. Ortega, and Southwest Airlines for your support and generosity. Now please turn to the screen for a message from tonight's co-sponsor, the Ford Motor Company Fund.
At Ford Motor Company, we are committed to driving a brighter future.
I want to thank the Ford Motor Company for impacting my life and believing in me.
We strive to build community through strong partnerships. These partnerships promote education, driving safety, and quality of life in communities where we work. We are building tomorrow's leaders.
I can really harness the things that I learned this past week, take it back to my community, and really help to make a difference.
Keeping Latino youth on the course to graduation and providing real-world experience to 100,000 high school students. Training teens to become safer drivers.
It's safety, and first and foremost, that's what we should care about.
Empowering women on the road.
I feel safer because I learned more about my car and features it has.
Partnering with institutions to expose Latino youth to the arts.
Latino Americans are part of the American fabric in every way you can imagine.
We honor heritage, culture.
The importance to many of the communities that I'll go to is it's going to tell a story about our history. It talks about the musicians, but really as you go through the exhibit, you can kind of put yourself in times and places when you heard that music and relate it to yourself and also relate what was happening in our country at that time. We know that through arts and culture, we can bring together diverse populations. There's a great educational component to this. So it reaches out to young people.
That's one of the most important things for me, to be proud of what I do, to be proud of who I am.
And provide social services. Each year, more than 20,000 Ford employees and retirees make a difference in communities worldwide. As a valued partner, Ford salutes you for helping to drive a brighter future.
And now to present the 2014 Affiliate of the Year Award from our longtime partners at the Ford Motor Company Fund, a warm welcome for Community Outreach Manager Joe Avila.
Good evening, buenas noches. On behalf of everyone at Ford Motor Company Fund, it is my pleasure to join you this evening. I would like to congratulate the leaders we are honoring today and tonight for your commitment to the Hispanic community. I would also like to commend Janet Murguia, Board Chair Jorge Plasencia, and the entire NCLR staff for all their hard work and dedication to advancing the Latino community. To be a stronger company, Ford believes we must strive not only to build innovative products, but also to work together to build a better world, one community at a time. This is the reason why Ford has partnered with organizations like NCLR for more than 25 years to help make a real difference in our communities. As our founder, Henry Ford, said, coming together is the beginning. Keeping together is progress. Working together is success. Ford Motor Company Fund proudly supports the NCLR affiliates through the Affiliate of the Year program to recognize and reward top affiliates for their extraordinary work with substantial grants. Tonight, I have this year's and the honor of announcing this year's National Affiliate of the Year winner, Congreso de Latinos Unidos de Philadelphia. There you go. Congreso de Latinos Unidos is the 18th largest Hispanic nonprofit in the nation and works to strengthen Hispanic communities through social, economic, education, and health services, leadership development, and advocacy. I would like to ask Janet to join me on a stage. And please pay attention to the screen for a brief video and look at this exceptional organization.
Congreso de Latinos Unidos, affectionately known as Congreso, was founded in 1977 by Puerto Rican activists. We really focus on education, employment, health, and social services. And by that, we're able to address a multitude of issues that face individuals in our community.
The atmosphere that we try to provide here at Congreso is one of family. We want someone to be able to walk into the door and feel like they are at home and feel like they are surrounded by family and by friends. Individuals come in through these doors and need help and need assistance, and our staff and our employees, we're here to help them through times of need. We're here to celebrate with them. We're here for them 24/7, just like any other family member would be.
Impactaría enormemente porque el Departamento de Violencia Doméstica en Congreso es clave aquí en Congreso. Han sido muchas mujeres y yo sé que van a seguir llegando. Aquí yo me siento en Congreso como si me siento en mi casa, porque es mi casa.
I was actually part of a program called Éxito. Éxito is a program that basically was offering music, culinary, art, theater, sports. I was very interested about the music. And the connection that we had with the teachers, it was great. That magic of trust between the teacher and the students. Congreso changed my life. I think that Congreso actually was the path to build that professional person that I am today.
Every child needs to know that they can succeed. And sometimes it's a little bit hard, you know, for an individual child to know that, to believe in oneself. But that's what Congreso is all about.
We really value impact. So Congreso is well known for our ability to measure our outcomes. What's the difference that you made in the lives of the individuals you served? So it's not just about how many, it's how well, and how were you able to reach the goal that that family wanted to reach together.
They have actually taken the lead in reaching out to other organizations in Florida, in North Carolina, in Minnesota, to share their best practices and to help other affiliates improve their ability to serve the community and have impact.
We have witnessed firsthand Congreso's evolution from a small grassroots organization to becoming a local force in Philadelphia worthy of national recognition for its commitment to comprehensive education, employment, health, and social services to support the underserved. In the last 10 years, we're proud to have invested nearly $1 million in Congreso programs.
I'm so proud of Congreso for being recognized by NCLR in this way. It's a well-deserved honor. Congreso stands out as a shining example for other nonprofits throughout not only Pennsylvania, but the country.
Mi Casa, Su Casa has been a philosophy that has carried the organization and continues to be relevant. We believe that this is a space for the community. This organization is for and about the community. So when you're on Congreso's campus, every door is an open door, and that everybody should feel like they've entered into their own house.
It is with great pleasure that I present the Affiliate of the Year Award to Congreso de Latinos Unidos, and to accept the award, welcome their President and CEO, Cynthia Figueroa.
Buenas noches. Thank you, Janet, Jorge, the NCLR Board of Directors, and the Ford Motor Company. Mi madre siempre dijo, dime con quién andes y te diré quién eres. I think my mom would know that Congreso is in great company with all the affiliates in the room. Thank you to the affiliates. Congreso here being recognized by NCLR as the Affiliate of the Year is a huge privilege and an honor to be among the Latino giants in our nation. The example the affiliates set in this nation to serve those most needed is really an honor and a privilege. I accept this award tonight on behalf of those we serve. The students who say presente to underfunded schools, women who are fleeing abusive partners, the abuela who wants to age in dignity in her own home, and the undocumented who come to our clinics because we're the place that will serve them in Philadelphia. Of course, I accept this award for the amazing staff who make the magic happen at Congreso. And I just want to take this moment to say I have some staff here and I would just like them to be recognized. We accept this honor on behalf of our partners and our board and all of those in the community. Lastly, I would just like to say that under Janet's leadership, the affiliate network, the need to nourish and grow that affiliate network is critical. And I think that we as affiliates have a responsibility to meet them halfway. We are to reach out again across city lines and state lines and say together, not by ourselves, we can make a difference to this community. Gracias, NCLR, gracias to the affiliates and to all of our partners.
Que como se menea, ella es ese sueño que tuve despierto, un recuerdo leve de esto que siento, una sacudida a mis salidas, la cima de un beso en un brinco suicida, su fuente de energía cautiva mis sensores, pues no hay quien la controle, cuando baila encendía, tiene dentro esa chispa que quema transistores, y bebe de un elixir que enciende sus motores, sanada disco baila una diva virtual, chequea cómo se menea.
Sus expectativas. De eso se trata. Algunos años luz antes que todos ustedes. Siempre voy a vivir ahí. No mire para mi galaxia.
Memorias, tus lindas memorias, y esas lindas.
las memorias de aquel lindo amor que perdí, perdí.
Wow. Buenas noches. ¿Cómo están? ¿Cómo están? Qué bueno. Those of us that were at the Gilberto Santa Rosa concert last night, if you're in the room, make noise. We had a good time last night, right? Well, that speaks to celebrating our culture and our people, and that's what we're doing here this evening. I want to say again on behalf of Janet, the board, our extraordinary staff, thank you. Thank you, Los Angeles, for receiving us in such an amazing way this year. It's been an amazing conference. And, you know, I personally just want to say thank you to so many of you that stop me and say such nice things. I will cherish and take those words and those feelings and those moments with me forever. So thank you very much. What a great looking crowd. It must be all the great thinking, creating, and aspiring that we've done here in the City of Angels these past 4 days. Hasn't this been an exceptional conference? Hasn't this been an exceptional conference? From being reminded to lean in, to stand by our friend Sheryl Sandberg, to standing room only workshops, the passionate town halls, and the learning and sharing, each of you have made this conference a huge success. Give yourselves a round of applause. Please join me in thanking some very special guests that are with us this evening. First, we'd like to acknowledge a few special and committed partners and supporters, the members of the National Council of La Raza's Corporate Board of Advisors. Round of applause for them. Thank you for bringing NCLR's vision to light with your financial support and partnership, and for being advocates of our community and our work within corporate America. Thank you so very much. We'd also like to recognize the Director of the U.S. Office of Personnel Management, Ms. Catherine Archuleta. Catherine. And somebody that I personally care for a lot and just a great guy, hailing from San Antonio, Texas, one of our great leaders. Thank you for being here. Chairman Emeritus of the Smithsonian National Latino Board, Mr. Henry Munoz. Another friend that we go way back, and I'm so proud that he recently got appointed the Executive Director of the National Hispanic Corporate Council, Octavio Hinojosa Mier. Octavio. And California State Assembly Member, the Honorable Jimmy Gomez. Jimmy. We're so proud you've joined us, and again, a round of applause for all of our guests tonight. Muchísimas gracias por estar aquí. And now, a moment that I will cherish, recognizing somebody that I care for, respect, admire, and we're all here in a big part thanks to him. We have one very special acknowledgement tonight to a civil rights icon and our dear friend, my dear friend, and that's the extraordinary embajador, Raul Yzaguirre. Today is Raul's big day. It's his birthday. So please join me in singing what more than Que Mejor Que Las Mañanitas. Is there music coming?
Son las mañanitas que cantaba el rey David. Hoy por ser día de tu santo, te las cantamos aquí. Despierta, mi bien, despierta. Mira que ya amaneció.
Raúl, muchas felicidades. Te queremos mucho y te deseamos todo lo mejor siempre. Muchas gracias a ti por todo lo que has hecho. Thank you, Raúl. And happy birthday again. We've heard so many inspiring stories these past 4 days. about our affiliates, our Latina leaders, a crucial new immigration initiative that we've launched, the future of education, our military servicemen and women, our heroes. And it's time now to settle in for a few more extraordinary examples. We've talked a lot about thinking, creating, and aspiring. But if you're still looking for something to aspire to, well, look no further than tonight's honorees. They may be, on paper alone, a district supervisor, an activist actress, a sports champion, a journalist, and a civic leader. But these folks carry forth a tenacity and a will to help the Latino community be its strongest, its most visible, and best self. And for this and many other feats, we are inspired by them tonight. Damas y caballeros, please turn your attention to the screens to learn more about these leaders and the legacy for which we honor them tonight at the National Council of La Raza.
Born Manuel Rafael Mota Jerónimo in Santo Domingo, Manny Mota is one of baseball's legendary players with a stellar career on the baseball diamond as an all-time great pinch hitter. In 1970, Mota set the career record of 150 pinch hits, a mark that stood for 21 years. Mota has made it to the World Series a whopping 5 times. For over 30 years, Manny and his wife, Margarita, have run the Manny Mota International Foundation, which provides educational, health, and recreational opportunities to disadvantaged youth and their families in both the Dominican Republic and the U.S.
I told my mother, I said, Mother, Mama, I will do the same thing you do. I will help the poor people because you teaching me how to do it. That's a great feeling.
With a baseball bat made of iron and a heart made of gold, Manny Mota instills pride across baseball diamonds around the world. A tireless advocate for immigrant rights, Angelica Salas is a national leader, a powerful organizer, and a trailblazing coalition builder. Angelica keeps her eye on the bigger vision of comprehensive immigration reform, while her heart is building a movement that will transform America.
For our families, we will do everything until we win. Para nuestras familias, ayudamos. Por nuestras familias, tomamos acción.
As the director of the Coalition for Humane Immigrant Rights of Los Angeles, Salas and her staff oversee programs that advocate for education, civic engagement, and community organizing. Her lifelong efforts have helped achieve numerous policy victories for immigrant workers, and more importantly, helped prepare immigrant groups to advocate on their own behalf. Angelica Salas' commitment and tenacity empower the immigrant community while she joins the march forward to help create a more just and humane society. He is part of a power trio of brothers, two of whom, as former congressmen, know the steps of the nation's Capitol building well. But José Díaz-Balart has paved his own path in the world of broadcast journalism.
Ustedes están presenciando el pánico.
Se transformó en una verdadera guerra.
Díaz-Balart is respected and known for getting to the heart of pivotal events that affect the Latino community.
People are wondering, won't you at least consider unilaterally freezing deportations for the parents of deferred action kids?
Blazing a trail through broadcast media, he's the first journalist to anchor daily network newscasts in both English and Spanish. A respected voice in both Spanish and English media, José Díaz-Balart is a pioneering journalist and a trusted friend of the Latino community.
You know, when you're among the first at something, I think you have an added responsibility so that in the future, a young kid that maybe has the same background as you can see you and say, if he can do it, I can do it.
And this election is another step in that positive path of the American promise.
Gloria Molina has proudly served the constituents of her first district in Los Angeles for almost three decades, forging a trail of firsts. She's the first Latina in the history of California to be elected to the state legislature, the first Latina elected to the Los Angeles City Council, and the first Latina to serve on the Los Angeles County Board of Supervisors.
The community I represent and the issues that they have, that's what keeps me going. I'm always motivated by what needs to be done in the community. I want them to be proud of the work that I have done along with my staff, and I hope they also feel empowered.
Known as a fighter and groundbreaking public servant, Gloria Molina leaves a legacy of visionary leadership, inclusion, and accomplishment. Born in Corpus Christi, Texas, Eva Longoria was raised with the family values of giving back, and she has taken that guidance to amazing levels.
In my family, there was one cardinal priority, education.
The Eva Longoria Foundation helps Latinas to access resources and create opportunities to build better futures for themselves and their families. The foundation supports numerous education programs and entrepreneurial goals. Eva Longoria has been instrumental in helping NCLR fulfill its mission of educating the American public about the Latino community's many contributions while improving our image in media.
Hello, welcome to the 2013 NCLR Alma Awards.
Her singular focus and commitment as executive producer and host of the NCLR Alma Awards, the only national televised program highlighting the Hispanic community in Hollywood, got the show back on the air and in the spotlight. Eva Longoria has set her heart and her mind on contributing to the advancement of the Latino community, instilling the belief that each of us can achieve greatness.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand as we welcome your 2014 NCLR Conference Award honorees with NCLR President and CEO Janet Murguia.
Thank you. For three decades, our first honoree, Gloria Molina, has been one of Los Angeles's most outspoken champions for the Latino community. Her strength and commitment to justice has been forged by her living in interesting times. The Chicano movement, the women's movement, the fight for civil rights, all gave her the fortitude that would become her guiding compass. For an amazing 23 years, she has served on the County Board of Supervisors, greatly shaping both her district and the city. She was at the forefront of the construction of the Metro Gold Line extension to the city's east side to provide much needed public transportation to her constituents. It was through her efforts that the county supported La Plaza de Cultura y Artes, a magnificent museum preserving the history of the city's Mexican roots and the Mexican-American community. Supervisor Molina's vision seeded the creation of this city's downtown oasis, blossoming into Grand Park, providing the city with a green heart for the families to enjoy. Each of those accomplishments are amazing endeavors, but what may be her crowning achievement as a county supervisor is the creation of the Los Angeles County USC Medical Center, giving low-income county residents a state-of-the-art facility to turn to for their health care needs. Once Gloria Molina committed herself to being of service to her community and her city, Latino politics in the state was never the same. Gloria has not only changed politics for the good, she has lived it. Gloria's dedication to our community, her love for our community, and her fearless leadership are a reflection of the late Graciela Olivarez, our own amazing grace, for whom this award is named. It is my pleasure and my honor to welcome the 2014 Graciela Olivarez Award honoree, the amazing Gloria Molina.
Muchísimas gracias y buenas noches. What an honor to be here today with all of you celebrating the tremendous success of the National Council de la Raza. It is amazing. I want to thank our ambassador, Raul, Yzaguirre, for putting it together and decades of service, but in particular to thank Janet Murguia for her courageous and outstanding leadership, taking on leaders across the board to advocate for our community and all of us who support National Council and their efforts. Congratulations to each of us for the good work that we do. I'm honored, of course, to be here in such a large gala and large room with the greats of José Díaz-Balart, our very own champion, Angelica Salas, the Mr. Great Manny Mota, and of course, the beautiful and talented Eva Longoria, all very deserving of their award. I'm particularly honored this evening to accept this award in the name of Graciela Olivares. It is an outstanding an award. I happen to be one of the people that had an opportunity to work alongside her. Now, keep in mind, I was a little peewee around Washington, D.C. I had the fortune of working in the Carter White House. And Graciela Olivares, at that time, was the highest-ranking Latina in this country. While yet not a cabinet secretary, she had a very prominent role as a head of a major agency and department, not yet a cabinet member. But she was a fascination to watch. She was an inspiration in everything that she did because she was so bold, so strong, and so very, very courageous, a true inspiration. Now, you have to understand and recognize this when you find out that she was the first Chicana ever to graduate from Notre Dame, and she didn't even have a high school degree. How that happened, only Graciela Olivares can make it happen. She was a very powerful woman. And of course, this is probably not polite to say in mixed company, but I have to say it because it means so much to us. I would have never said it way back in 1976 when I did get to meet her. She was a very scary person for me. You got to know that. And I'm going to get frightened by many people. But anyway, I would say she was the first chingona in Washington, D.C. Which we all aspire to be, by the way. We loved her courage. Well, after having that experience and watching wonderful people like that in top leadership roles, I came home and had an opportunity to continue my work in the community. But I was very fortunate. In 1982, I had my own little pleitito with the men in my community, and I was fortunate to be elected as the first Latina ever to the California State Legislature. Which, of course, led to being the first Latina elected to the City Council, and as Janet said, the first Latina to the County Board of Supervisors, What makes that prominent, besides the importance of the role that I play on the board, one of five, representing 2 million of the 10 million residents that we represent here, is the fact that this seat was won by the Mexican American Legal Defense and Education Fund. They had to file a lawsuit that went all the way, let's give them a round of applause, all the way to the US Supreme Court, because they had gerrymandered Latinos out of an opportunity to be a part of the government of LA County. At that time, we represented at least 28% of the population. It took them over 10 years, and in 1991 is when the ruling came down, or actually 1990, and of course, that created the Opportunity District in which I had an opportunity to run with, of course, 11 other Chicanos from the east side of town, which created that great opportunity. It has always been an honor for me to represent the community that I represent. I hope I do it with the kind of work and effort and more so having Graciela looking down at us and saying, así es como se hace. I really think that championing our community is an unbelievable honor. It's something that I get up for every day and I look forward to. And it's always a challenge. As you know, there is so much that needs to be done and continues to need to be done. And we hope that through the work of National Council, through the work of leaders across this room, that we are going to see great leaders continuing to evolve, continue to be inspired by so many others. And what I'm so very proud of is that everything that we do, I think we are all on shoulders of one another, hopefully recognizing that we did not get here alone. Every one of us had that kind of support. And it's so wonderful to have an organization like National Council that is nacional, that is everywhere, that is bold and strong, and continues to advocate for our community. We are the fastest growing population. We have duties and responsibilities for the future. We are going to be playing very critical leadership roles. So we need to get there quickly. We need to get there. We need to operate with integrity. We need to be bold and strong and never forget where we came from. Muchísimas gracias. This is a great honor.
Congratulations, Gloria. Yeah, sure. Incredible career. Throughout his storied career, José Díaz-Balart has effortlessly straddled both English language and Spanish language news media. In fact, he was the first person ever to anchor a national news show in English and one in Spanish simultaneously. Jose's unique position is a powerful one as he gives voice to the Latino community and offers a keen understanding and sensitivity of the issues of concern to us that he helps convey to a non-Latino television audience. Jose's pioneering career bridged barriers between English language and Spanish language network news coverage at a time when NCLR and other Latino organizations were increasingly vocal about growing the political power of the Latino community. And we are thrilled that just this month, he became the first Latino to anchor his own show on MSNBC while still serving as anchor of Noticiero Telemundo and host of Telemundo's public affairs program, Enfoque. He is a true trailblazer. Jose has been recognized with numerous awards for his work, including the George Foster Peabody Award, the Alfred I. DuPont Columbia University Award, and the Broadcasting and Cable Channel Award, Multi-Channel Award News for 2012, and an award for an outstanding achievement in Hispanic television. Jose is also a philanthropist with a special interest in educational issues
and the betterment of the Latino community. In addition to NCLR, he has worked with the Aspen Institute, the Congressional Hispanic Caucus Institute, Education for a Better America, and numerous business and cultural and Latino institutions. As Latinos continue to demand attention in the news coverage of the issues important to them, we can count on José. NCLR values his unwavering commitment, and today we honor him with the Ruben Salazar Award for Communications. Please welcome our honoree of the 2014 Ruben Salazar Award for Communications, the amazing José Díaz-Balart.
Thank you so much. Muy buenas noches. Qué lindo grupo de amigos reunidos aquí esta noche. And Don Raul, thank you. Thank you for being one of the pillars of our community. Janet, nuestra leona. Nuestra leona. En inglés y en español. Jorge, the new leadership that we so need and so admire in people like you. Ladies and gentlemen, try to make a difference. That's been the leitmotif of my life and my 30 years in journalism. On that journey, the most important lessons I've learned have come not from the famous or the powerful, but from those who live their lives in quiet humility, serving others. In these three decades of covering the world, of interviewing princes and presidents, villains and heroes, nothing has been more rewarding than being able to shine a light on those who serve with humility and perseverance, quietly working, creating their own legacy of service, su legado de servicio personal, and asking for nothing in return. People like Luis Gatica, a paramedic I met in the aftermath of an earthquake and tsunami in Chile that had killed his wife, his only child, along with his brother, his sister-in-law, and their son. They were ripped from his grasp by a tsunami. He never found their bodies. I met him 2 days later, and he was treating little children the age of his lost daughter and saying to them, "Your future is bright. Never look at the past. Look towards the future." Or Maria, the 17-year-old Honduran girl whom we all met last week on my new show on MSNBC. Gang members killed her brother in front of her face, and then they came back to her house to get her. She fled to the United States. She has a sister in this country. The journey to this country was a living hell. She says she fears being deported back to Honduras. She says that would be a life sentence. Excuse me, that would be a death sentence for her, she told me. And you know what? She just got here and she's already learning English. And her dreams are to become a nurse in this country, to serve little kids in the United States of America. Her payback for being in this country. Humble people living their own legacy of service quietly and asking for nothing in return. In these 30 years on television, I had a lot more hair and a lot less pounds than I do today. Those stories are the stories that give me faith in the future and faith in my profession. Today, I remain as enthusiastic and determined as I was in 1984 to serve, to try and make a difference. And I so look forward to the next phase of my career and this, the calling of my life. Ruben Salazar, one of the pillars of journalism in any language. Los Angeles, native son. Extraordinary, extraordinary, the legacy that he has left us and that he will continue to leave us.
I am deeply honored to receive this recognition by the National Council of La Raza, and I do so thinking of those whose unmitigated acts of love and compassion helped define my life, and grateful to those who have given me the opportunity, indeed the privilege, to be able to live my American dream and continue to try and make a difference. Muchísimas gracias.
Congratulations, José. And before I move to our next honoree, the president of MSNBC, Phil Griffin, is here tonight. This is José's boss. Let's thank Phil Griffin for putting José on the air and giving us an hour for that kind of viewing and including the diversity on our show. Phil, thank you for being here. We want more José Díaz-Balart. We want more Latinos on MSNBC. Thank you, Phil, for doing this groundbreaking work with us and for being here tonight. On to our next incredible honoree. Angelica Salas is a champion of the Latino community, and her work has touched thousands of people across the state, across the country. She has spearheaded campaigns that helped result in in-state college tuition, driver's licenses, and day labor job centers for undocumented immigrants. She has transformed the model of immigrant assistance organizations from providing services to being centers of advocacy and empowerment, a place where immigrants can educate themselves to stand up for their rights and work for a fair wage with dignity. Angelica is now expanding her impact, fighting on the national level, building coalitions to achieve real and meaningful immigration reform. Even in this political atmosphere, she is undaunted. Never say no to this woman. She is a powerful and comfortable walking the barrios of Los Angeles as she is working the halls and corridors of Washington, D.C. This award, named after Maclovio Barraza, the founding chairperson of the Southwest Council of La Raza, recognizes those who work for our community where change is felt most, the grassroots level. It is with great pride that I welcome the honoree of the Maclovio Barraza Award for Leadership to the incomparable, the hardworking, the championing, the never tireless advocate for our community, Angelica Salas.
Good evening, everybody. And I just want to start by saying thank you. Thank you to the National Council of La Raza for representing our community and for this incredible award. I'm very humbled. I'm humbled to receive this award on behalf of my CHIRLA family, the organization that I work with, the staff, the board, and most importantly, the immigrant leaders. They are the workers, they are the day laborers, the domestic workers, they are the street vendors, they are the people that work in our restaurants, that they are the people who do so much for this country, so much for their community, and aren't receiving what they deserve. But they do one thing, they fight for their families, they fight for themselves, and they fight to make this country better through their efforts. And it is on their behalf that I receive this award. This is an opportunity for me to also say thank you to my family. As an immigrant from Mexico, it's tough sometimes to really make it in this country. But it's been because of my family, my mother, my sisters, and certainly my husband, who's an immigrant from El Salvador, who's here with me tonight, and my little girl, Maya, who I want her to be surrounded by powerful Latinas and Latinos so that she has pride in her community, and she too works on their behalf. tonight is extra special as I receive this award with these amazing, amazing leaders. Gloria Molina, everything that she's done for our city, for our county, for our state, thank you so much. José Díaz-Balart, wow, we couldn't get our message out without you. You allow us to tell our stories. Manny Mota, especially thankful to be here today with Manny Mota, because we, when we came to this country, one of the ways we integrated into this country is becoming by a full-hearted Dodger fan family. So, everybody in my family plays baseball, and I played softball all the way through college. Manny Mota was our hero. So to be sitting next to him is what an honor. And of course, Eva Longoria, who represents us on film and represents us on television with such honor. And we look at you and we're so thankful. So I'm very, very honored and feel humbled to be with you today. Today that we all gather at NCLR, at the NCLR conference and in these in this awards gala, we are in a moment of critical, critical importance for our community here in the United States. As many of you know, our NCLR leaders through Janet Murguia, Clarissa Martinez, Charles Kamasaki, and so many others have been bold and amazing in their fight for immigration reform. They have been incredible, incredible, fearless champions. And I want to take this time to say thank you to Janet for standing up for our community and saying the truth about what was happening and what needed to be done. To represent all the community who is suffering from family separation. We were abandoned on the issue of immigration reform by Republicans who were given an opportunity to stand with us. There are many of them who want to be, who want to advance with us, but they didn't come far enough, and we do not have immigration reform now. We have to hold our elected officials accountable because they are not representing America, and we are America. So now we have administrative relief. And the President Barack Obama has said that administrative relief is going to come. It's going to come by the end of summer. So we in this room have to ensure that it's no longer promises, but it's a reality. That our families stay together, that our children have an opportunity, that workers are treated with dignity and respect in the workplace. And if administrative relief is going to do it, then let's have administrative relief, but let's have it now. And finally, I want to talk about the children, our children at our borders. And I want to say one more time, this is a humanitarian emergency that requires a humanitarian response. And that response is giving those children full protection, due process, and everything a child that has gone through so much pain and hardship deserves, care. We do not have a humanitarian crisis. We have a humanitarian emergency. The crisis we do have is a crisis of leadership. A crisis of leadership that would take these children's lives, the horrors that they have suffered, and turn it around for political gain. That has to stop, and we can do it. Each one of us here in this room can raise our voices in favor of our families. In August, our elected representatives are going to come across, they're going to come back home to their districts. I need every single one of you to reach out to the member of Congress who's done the right thing and to say thank you. And if your member of Congress is not doing the right thing by our families, let him know. Let her know. Because we need to be a powerful force in defense of our families. We are many, but we need to be many fierce advocates on behalf of ourselves and on behalf of our future. And I know that with NCLR, we can be that powerful force. With many of the organizations here and all the leaders who are here, we can be that powerful force. So let's not stay quiet, fight for our rights, fight for our future, and make America great the way that we know how to. So thank you very much, and I'm so appreciative of this incredible honor.
Wow, thank you.
you. Gracias. Congratulations, felicidades. Generations of baseball fans know Manny Mota from 13 seasons as an outfielder, then 33 seasons as coach, the longest streak in Los Angeles Dodgers history. As famed sports writer Jim Murray once described, Mota could wake up at 2 o'clock in the morning and hit an aspirin tablet with a toothpick, lining it to the right field for a single. His talents moved from the diamond to the announcer booth when in 2010, Spanish-speaking fans got to know him as the voice of expert commentary on Spanish language broadcasts. But Mota's excellence on and off the field as a Los Angeles Dodger is just one part of a distinguished career that gives back to those around him. With his wife, Margarita, Manny founded the Manny Mota International Foundation, with its mission to provide educational, health, and recreational opportunities for underprivileged and disadvantaged youth. Baseball continues to be his means to reach the people. We are grateful for the many lives touched and uplifted by his generosity. The Roberto Clemente Award is presented to an individual renowned in the world of sports and committed to the advancement of Hispanic Americans. That is our honoree tonight. With great pleasure, I present the 2014 Roberto Clemente Award for Sports Excellence to Mr. Dodger himself, Manny Mota.
Muchas gracias. Buenas noches. Good evening. Primeramente quiero darle gracias a Dios por permitirme estar aquí esta noche. I'd like to thank God for giving me the opportunity of being here tonight. Gracias. Salud. Thank you to the National Council of Raza for this great honor they give me tonight, for selecting me to receive this prestigious award, Mr. Roberto Clemente Award. You people don't know who Roberto Clemente was. He was what Jackie Robinson was for the African American. That was Roberto Clemente for the Latino players and the Latino people. Roberto, without a doubt, I've been in this game forever, and he was the best hitter I ever saw playing this game. I've been with the Dodgers for 46 years. Thanks God for them to keep me for so many years. I'm very grateful to the Dodger organization. Roberto was a very humble person, very simple person, but he got a great character. He was a person who never tolerated injustice. He was not afraid to express his feeling and say what he thinks about it. He cared about people. Besides being the great player he was great and excellent human being. He cared for people. He was so proud to be a Latino and represent his country, Puerto Rico, in pride and dignity. He was a great, great person. I don't want to talk too much about the foundation because they already talked about the foundation. But we're very proud to be able, and we are blessed from the Lord for giving my wife and my family the opportunity to touch so many lives in the Dominican Republic and also in LA. That's a blessing for Lord. And any time you get opportunity to spend time with the children, remember one thing. The children, they are the hope, they are the pride, and they are the future of this country and any country. I don't want to take too much time now. The only thing I'm going to say is this. I'm proud to be from the Dominican Republic. Thank you. Proud to be part of the best organization in baseball, which they're going to go to the World Series this year. But we cannot do it without you. We need your support because you are the number 10 player on the lineup. Okay, talking about proud, I've been proud to be part of this great nation because they give me the opportunity to become to be somebody in baseball. Thank you very much. God bless you and God bless America. Thank you.
Congratulations. What amazes me about Eva Longoria is when she commits to a cause, an organization, a goal, she gives 1,000%, offering her time, her wisdom, and her heart. Whether it's children and families facing medical challenges, or farm workers who need their voices heard, or helping a class of young students continue their education, Eva is set on every Latino having the chance to live to their full potential. Having just earned her master's degree in Chicano studies and political science, Eva uses her platform to advocate for issues of concern for our community. This is no small thing. And it's not something, unfortunately, that many celebrities or Latino celebrities feel that they can do. She takes risks and shows courage in standing up and supporting Latinos across the country. It was with Eva's support and guidance that we were able to bring back the ALMA Awards and make them better than ever as our longtime host and executive producer, putting a spotlight on our community. Her commitment to NCLR's mission and vision doesn't end with the ALMA Awards, though. The Eva Longoria Foundation, which she established in 2010, helps Latinas to access resources and opportunities to build better futures for themselves and their families through education and entrepreneurship. The Raul Yzaguirre President's Award is presented to a person who has shown outstanding support for NCLR's mission, goals, and philosophy. And that defines Eva Longoria, who I am privileged to know and call a dear friend. I'm honored to present this award to a true friend of NCLR and a champion for the Latino community, the incomparable Eva Longoria.
Buenas noches. You guys are more excited that it's the last speech of the night. Not so much that it's me. thank you, Janet, for this amazing honor. She's been trying to honor me for so many years, and I never like it. I never have accepted it before, because especially with the Raul Award, because Raul is such a pioneer in creating what NCLR is today, and we are all just humbly following in your footsteps, Raul. So I'm honored to receive this award in your name. Thank you so much. I am so humbled to be before so many individuals who have accomplished so much for our community. Everybody on this stage, Gloria, José, Angelica, Manny, you know, Gloria's been one of my mentors for a long time, so I've learned from the best. I feel like I've never wanted to receive this honor because my work has just begun. I don't think I've even begun to tap into the full potential that I have as an activist, as an actor, as a woman, as an American. There is so much to be done, and I am so grateful for this recognition from NCLR, which is an organization that really does most of the work for us. Our job is just to follow their lead. You know, Janet, your advocacy for social justice and better opportunities for Hispanic Americans is exactly the reason why I have been a member for so long and have supported your mission of NCLR. This is my seventh year producing the exec producing and hosting the Alamo Awards, and I'm so very proud of it. 7 years. That's why Janet's so sick of me. I remember when we first started having to explain to ABC who Pitbull was. and us going, he has the number one song in the nation. And they were saying, in Spanish language, we go, no, in the nation. But you know, the goal of the Alamo Awards is to honor and applaud positive images of Latinos in the media, whether it be film or television or music or sports or fashion. A lot of people think that the Alamo Awards are just this glamorous award show and red carpets and celebrities showing up, but it's not. It is so much more than that. It is an opportunity for us to shape the narrative of how this country defines us and how to recognize the contributions that Latino artists make to American pop culture. And it's an opportunity for people to see we are not just what you see on the news. It's for people to know that we're not just synonymous with the word immigrant. We're not synonymous with drug cartel. We're not synonymous with not from here. We are so much more. And we've been an integral part of building this country, and the Alamas is just one way in which we can put our best face forward and say, look at us, this is what we've done, this is how we've contributed. So I thank Phil for letting us continue this journey on MSNBC. We've had so much fun taking over MSNBC. and we're excited to do it again this year. A lot of you have heard me speak many times, and you know I grew up in South Texas on a ranch near the border. And yay, Texas! Other Texicans. And I remember growing up, we used to go to the border all the time. We would cross over for lunch, we would come back, we would go buy medicine, we'd come back, my dad would go buy liquor, we'd come back. And it was so easy and safe and common. And I just remember there was always this really long line, and then there was these little lines that we went to, and my dad would always say, don't forget to say American citizen. And so we get to the border, and I would go, American citizen, and then they'd let us through. There was no checking of passports at that time and no papers to show. You just said, American citizen. And I remember telling my dad, why doesn't everybody in that line just say American citizen? And he said, you know, I really thought they were magic words. I thought, like, they don't know the magic words. And my dad said, no, they can't say American citizen because they were born on the other side. El otro lado. And I said, well, why were we born on this side? And he said, because we were lucky. And I just think, I mean, I can't help but think or reflect on the situation that's happening now on the border, and I know, like Angelica talked about a little bit, everything that's unfolding on our borders, 57,000 children who did not have the luck to be born an American. Little is being done to understand who these children are, where they're coming from, what they're facing. They had the bad luck to be born in poor and violent countries of Central America. These children are running for their lives, and they believe that the United States will protect them. And will we is the question, and I don't know. I'm surprised at the handling of it. Americans of every background are disappointed with how the issue has been handled, and I think it's time, like Angelica said, for leaders from both parties to set aside partisan bickering and their own narrow political goals and get immigration reform done. How it's been handled has just been unbelievable, unacceptable, and un-American. Now, although, you know, NCLR's origins can be traced back to the civil rights movement and many of these efforts and gains in the 60s, so many are being dismantled today right in front of our eyes. Whether it has to do with education or access to education for Latinos or access to healthcare for Latinos, immigration reform, so many of this, we're taking two steps backwards. And so it is up to us and the leaders in this room and the leaders on this stage to make sure that those gains are not lost and that we continue to move this country forward as Latinos always have. So I thank you from the bottom of my heart for this award, Janet and NCLR, and I will continue to always support your mission. Thank you so much.
Felicidades, Eva, and to all of our honorees. This is a remarkable group, and I couldn't be prouder to share the stage tonight with them. Let's give them all another round of applause and ask them to stand and take a bow and thank them, because combined, these folks have moved mountains on behalf of our Latino community. Thank you for your legacy of service. I'm going to ask you all to please exit the stage, and thank you for so many, many wonderful advancements on behalf of our community. So we're wrapping up the evening here, and I just want to say many thanks again to each and every one of you, to all of our conference sponsors. These sponsors deserve a round of applause as well, because without their support and enthusiasm, would not allow us to continue our work around the country, providing opportunities for Latino community and all other communities. And folks, let's make a commitment tonight to support the companies that support us. So I thank them again. I'd also like to thank the many volunteers who work tirelessly for NCLR, for bringing this conference to Los Angeles, California, and making it a wonderful conference. Muchísimas gracias. And to my incredible NCLR staff, these are folks who work tirelessly every day on behalf of our community. We would not be able to do this conference or the work of NCLR without them. To the incredible board of directors of the NCLR, all of these board members bring their talents and exceptional talents to us. Our board chair, Jorge Plasencia, who we've put to work, former board chairs. And if you'll just indulge me 1 minute, I also want to just say briefly a brief thanks to my family who supports me personally as I carry on the work. Many of them are all here. And I guess our family is growing in many ways. My nephew Ryan got married, and we have a new person in the family. And while I announced this in Kansas City's reception the other night, I haven't announced this here, but in March, I got engaged. And so my life is changing. Yes. We buried the headline. Anyhow, so my fiancé and his family is here tonight, so I'd appreciate it if you would thank this incredible man who I am grateful to for his support, Mauro Morales. Mauro, where are you? Stand up somewhere. Oh, man.
What's he doing sitting back there? You would think he would have better connections up there. Well, I guess it'll be different after we're married. We'll see. Gotta wait till it's done, right? Okay. You know, I share personal news with you all because to me, this is my life's work, and NCLR, its board, its staff, and you all, our supporters, are part of the NCLR familia. And we could not carry on the work and the mission of this great organization without you. I am grateful to the staff. I am grateful to you all. I appreciate what you do to come together and support us every year for this conference. But more than anything else, I appreciate the support you give us every day. Let's go on to Kansas City next year and have a wonderful and incredible conference. Adelante. Muchísimas gracias a todos ustedes. Nos vemos en Kansas City, donde yo soy. Muchísimas gracias. Thank you. We have a reception afterwards. Thank you to the staff, Ron Estrada and your team, all the NCLR leadership team. Muchísimas gracias.